I came into this completely blind. I've never been around really any kind of animals. I never had pets growing up. I'd never been around horses. And on top of that, I didn't know what I was dealing with this specific donkey. He was locked away in a stall, being held captive by a hoarder, so he didn't know people. So the two of us were basically dealing, each of us dealing with an unknown species. He saw me as a threat because the last human he dealt with had locked him up in a box and kept him there for years. So he looks at me and I'm like the last species he wants to cooperate with. So the two of us had this big gap of misunderstanding and ignorance to overcome before we could get anywhere.
The journey of bridging that gap between writer Chris McDougall and a neglected donkey named Sherman wouldn't be easy. But as Chris would learn, it's the type of connection rooted deep within us all. I'm Doug Fraser, and this is What We Do, where we'll meet the people behind the most intriguing passions, hobbies, and jobs around the world. When he took Sherman home, Chris's idea was to heal him, then place him out in the field with the sheep and goats. That is, until he told his idea to Tanya, a local equine expert with a donkey of her own in his rural Pennsylvania town.
She nipped it in the bud right off the bat. She said, you're not just going to park him out there. He's already been abandoned. He's already feeling despair. You got to give him something to look forward to.
Like humans, donkeys are creatures of movement. Exercise gives them life. It helps fight depression, gives shots of endorphins, and signals our bodies to heal. Sherman needed a reason to move. The solution?
Find him a job, which is, great advice until you're the guy holding on to a donkey trying to figure out what the hell am I going to do? I'm going to go looking for gold. What am I going to do with a donkey? And I realized we had inherited this life or death problem. We had a creature that was desperately sick that I'd just been told needed to move and move a lot in order to survive.
But donkeys are notoriously stubborn creatures, and even more so in the face of stress. Chris needed first to understand how to communicate with this creature he rescued from a hoarder. In Chris's book, Running with Sherman, The Donkey with the Heart of a Hero, he offers a quote from the famous dog trainer, Caesar Millan. In the animal world, Caesar says, everything is energy.
We absorb each other's energy and we do it instinctively and we react to it before we even process it on a mental level. And his point was that when you're dealing, it's hard enough to deal with people on a verbal level, but imagine you're trying to communicate with a creature that's nonverbal.
The animal, be it a dog or donkey, is zeroing in on your cues, how you're holding yourself, whether you're fidgeting or anxious, and all that comes out in the form of energy. There's a universal truth when it comes to communicating with animals, one that Tanya passed along to Chris.
Everything you're feeling travels down the reins.
Which means anything you're feeling, the horse picks up on. And the same truth applied to Sherman.
I realized that if I were going to get this donkey to cooperate with me, I had to come into every contact just calm, relaxed, before we could advance.
For now, Sherman laid his head down for the first night at his new home. He was exhausted, ill, and feeling alone in the world. The first creature who had a breakthrough with Sherman was a rambunctious goat named Lawrence. Countless times, Chris would hear a horn honking out front, breaking through the morning air. It was the school bus driver. Lawrence had hopped the fence again and followed the kids onto the bus. And that's no small act. The fence around Chris's pasture is 5 feet tall.
And he can clear that thing like a deer. And that's what he would do. He'd just jump over the fence and take off looking for adventure.
The night Sherman arrived, he was sick, hardly moving, and a bit shell-shocked. Rather than kick up midnight mischief, Lauren showed a different side of his personality.
This goat sought him out and lay down next to him and spent the first night by his side.
The act of compassion seemed to bring Sherman to life. Sherman's first foray into movement was to follow Lawrence around. Then Tanya brought over her donkey and rode him next to Sherman as she walked. Chris's daughter spent time with him, continuing his increase in movement. It finally hit Chris that Sherman, this donkey who had been neglected for so long, just wanted companionship.
So as long as we surrounded him by other creatures, then he'd be interested in moving.
Over time, Chris and Sherman's bond grew. They ran together, eventually competing in the World Championship Pack Burrow Race, a tradition that began back in the early days of the Colorado mining industry. Miners had such strong bonds with their donkeys that it was commonplace for them to go wherever their humans went. Walk into a bar in a mining town and you'd see a line of humans, their donkeys at their side. In his continued research for understanding how to train and bond with animals, Chris stumbled across the biophilia hypothesis, which suggests humans have an innate desire to connect with things in nature, including other animals.
The sense is that we thrive and survive by partnering with animals, not subjugating them or dominating them, but looking to them for guidance and companionship, which will then make us smarter and stronger. When a dog comes into a room, you watch every single person is fixed on the dog. Everybody wants to pet the dog and stroke the dog and ask its name. But there's a reason, because if that dog is on your side, you now have a creature that's faster than you, stronger than you, a better hunter than you, that is now partnering with you. And that's why your body gets flooded with serotonin and oxytocin, these happy hormones, which tell you, good, you're in a good place. Keep this thing going. It's just sort of depressing how ignorant we are today in what our ancestors always knew and took for granted. Once we discovered sort of machines, you know, we didn't need to ride horses anymore. We could have food delivered to our door. We didn't need to actually have a cow in the neighborhood. And we kind of forgot all those sort of ancestral truths.
In modern culture, our deep connection with the animal world can feel severed. But signs of that bond are all around us. It's in our love for cat videos, or the feeling we get when we see a baby giraffe take its first steps. Some of us have a stronger sense of that bond, including actor Jimmy Stewart.
He didn't save enough money to send Harry to school, let alone me, but he did help a few people get out of your slums, Mr. Potter.
Jimmy was notoriously good with animals, especially on set. In one instance, while filming a Western, Jimmy was able to connect with a horse no one else could get close to. When it came time to start rolling, the horse was supposed to walk by itself from one point to the next, unassisted. After Jimmy spoke with it, the cameras rolled. This supposedly wild and unruly horse nailed it on the first take. Jimmy's connection with animals extended to his home life, with his dog, Bo, whom he wrote a poem about. This is part of that poem, which he read on Johnny Carson's Tonight Show.
And there were nights when I'd feel this stare, and I'd wake up and he'd be sitting there, and I'd reach out to stroke his hair, and sometimes I'd feel him sigh, and I think I know the reason why. He'd wake up at night and he would have this fear of the dark, of life, of lots of things, and he'd be glad to have me near.
At first, I went into it with this kind of monolithic, all donkeys are the same, they're all Eeyore, and figure out Eeyore, not realizing that all donkeys have individual personalities, quirks. What I started to understand about Sherman was, man, he is like cued in, dude. This guy could probably be like a safecracker, pulling off jewelry heist if he wanted to. He's that smart. Seriously, man, that observant, that innovative, he's a crafty one.
Early humans not only realized the benefits of partnering with other species, but also that personalities aren't exclusively human. In an age where we try to squeeze an hour out of a minute, it's important we take pause to appreciate the connections we have with the creatures in our lives. Whether it's your dog, a friendly squirrel at the park, or a donkey in need of a friend. Hey guys, thanks so much for listening. Would you mind leaving a rating and review for the show? It only takes a moment and it's a huge help. And be sure to subscribe so you don't miss any new episodes. Until next time, stay curious. What We Do is produced by me, Doug Fraser, for WHRO Public Media.